Last season, the Boston Renegades held on to top the Pittsburgh Passion in a close game, a thriller here in Pittsburgh. Then they ran all the way to the national championship, only to lose to Dallas 31-21. Tonight, the Passion look to avenge last year's loss. Hi, and a very pleasant good evening to you with former Pittsburgh Passion star Jennifer Cairns. I'm Chris Shublin. It's Passion football time, and it's a football night here in the West Hills of Pittsburgh at Joseph P. DeMichelis Stadium at West Allegheny. Jen, it's the Passion and the Boston Renegades, and, you know, this is kind of like the Steelers and the Patriots in New England.
It is. You know, we have a long history of edge-of-your-seat games and competitions. They always come out to shootouts in the last seconds of the game. Unfortunately, the Pittsburgh Passion have been on the losing ends of those shootouts, but tonight they're hoping and believing that it'll be different.
And last season, it was Boston jumping out to a 13-0 early lead in that game. Pittsburgh made it close, but dropped a 33-28 decision. They have got to get off to a better start this time.
And they intend to. They have a game plan around that. They look to smack them in the face early, and they just need to execute.
A lot of new faces on this Passion roster, but a lot of veterans have returned. We're seeing a team that's in flux right now.
It's a good mix, but they got a good chemistry. And one of the players that to watch tonight is one of those returning veterans. It's number 17, Rachel Wadowski. We are certainly excited to see her back on the field in the black and gold. And watching her and Horton, it's as though they've never lost a beat. She's been the leading wide receiver for the Pittsburgh Passion in years past, and she plans to be a real threat on the field tonight.
All right, let's see how they're going to get it done. What are the UPMC sports medicine keys to victory this evening?
Well, the one key to victory for the Pittsburgh Passion is to slay that mental dragon. I mean, this is a team that they have battled with, battled closely year after year, and come on the opposite end of the winning scenario in which they wanted to be in. And so they have to be prepared to ride the waves of the up and downs of this game and then execute at the end where it matters most.
Okay, UPMC Sports Medicine, the official sports medicine provider of the Pittsburgh Passion. That sets it up. Right now, we're going to talk with one of the Passion stars, Tara Catone, and that kickoff is right around the corner. Kickoff is right around the corner, but before we get to kickoff time, it's time to talk with one of the Passion stars. And Jen, we have Tara Catone with us. It is Slippery Rock University night here at the Pittsburgh Passion Boston Renegades game. So it's apropos that we have a Slippery Rock Rocket with us tonight.
That's right. This is one of their proudest and finest alumni. And so we'd love to hear how you got prepared for a game like Boston as the home opener over the 16th season of the Pittsburgh Passion.
Well, study, Jen. I think it's just looking at, consistencies within the team, being prepared, and then going through, executing, and then, again, practice. So we've been really preparing. We are coming off a bye week and just had a lot of time to study and make intelligent decisions on how we're preparing, and we really feel great on our execution plan for today's game.
Tara, I know you've had some of the most prolific offensive performances, not only in individual games, but for a season as a Passion running back. Let's talk about your career and how it's gone for you.
It's been interesting. It's been some up and downs, but I'm happier to start the season healthy, completely healthy. So I'm looking to get back on the offense and some defensive front. So just going out there and just being an athlete, I think, is a lot of things we set in our game plan and just as a personal goal as well.
So what would you say to some of those young, prospective, future Passion players sitting at Slippery Rock University now studying for finals about getting out of those seats and getting on this field with yeah. you next year?
The sky is the limit. Even though you might feel like you don't have any experience in football because women have limited possibilities for football at a young age, that this is awesome and it's made such a difference. Athlete or not, or you don't think you're an athlete, everyone can play the game of football and learn from the building basics and then getting up into high competitions like today's game.
Finally, Tara, what sports got you ready to play full contact football?
Oh, that's a good question. I say a basketball, a little backyard football growing up. definitely some track and field, I think all around. All sports kind of transferred those skills into playing the game of football.
Well, us and the rest of the Slippery Rock family are ready to see you get out there and light it up tonight. Good luck.
Yeah, thank you. Go Rock.
All right, and go Passion. Home opener for the Pittsburgh Passion as we get set for the 2018 home season to commence. And the rival Boston Renegades in town tonight to take on the Passion here at Joseph P. DeMichelis Stadium here in West Allegheny. Chris Shublin with Jen Cairns. Glad to have you along with us here tonight. Passion won the toss, Jen, and decided to defer. So Boston will receive the opening kickoff.
Yeah, well, you know, that's not an uncharted territory for the Pittsburgh Pash, and they'll often put it on the defense's back, and that's what they're going to do. They're going to trust that their defense can get it done in this opening series.
See how it pays off. Well, the officials, I believe, are going to turn the field here and have the Pash kick the other direction, or are they? It looks like the referee is signaling that they should be switching sides, and that's exactly what they're going to be doing. So the Passion will be kicking right to left from our press box vantage point, and the ball will be teed up at the 35-yard line. This could be a promising season for Pittsburgh, as again a mixture of veteran players, including some of the original peaches, as you like to call them, still on this roster, along with some very vital and vibrant youngsters.
Yeah, you know, some of my original colleagues still out there getting it done, with some new youth helping them fill the gaps for some veterans who've stepped off the field.
I heard people, when you were walking through the stadium proper tonight, wondering if you were ever going to get back out there again.
I would love to. I just, you know, it's not this year. We'll see. We'll see.
Uh-oh, there may be something coming in the future. Here's Kirsten Green with a kickoff, and it'll travel end over end. It will bounce inside the 30. Taking on the hop and reversing field with it is Shante Bond. She'll turn the corner, 40, 45, and up near the 50-yard line before she's finally run out. We have flags flying out of the sky on the bump out over on the far side where the Boston Renegades bench is. No love lost between these two clubs, is there?
No, there's not. Long history between them of close, hard-fought games. Imagine another one is in the mix for tonight. Looks like 49, Smith was the one who pushed the ball carrier out of bounds.
It is a personal foul against Pittsburgh, so that will give Boston some extra yardage. As a matter of fact, the Renegades are going to have excellent starting position. They will have the football at the Pittsburgh 35-yard line after Bonds was run out of bounds on that far side. So now Boston goes to work offensively. First down and 10. Renegades with the first touch of the football here tonight. Pittsburgh with a stacked defense, and the handoff is going to go to the left to Angelica Pascual, and she'll turn the corner down to the 30 and inside to the 28-yard line for a pickup of 7 yards. Cahill making the stop for Pittsburgh after a 7-yard gain by Pascual. Second down, 3 yards to go for Boston. And the fullback will carry on a jump back handoff play, and that is Bonds, the running back, tackled behind the line of scrimmage, and good coverage that time by Pittsburgh. They'll lose 2 yards on the carry. It's going to be third down and 5. Look, a strange kind of handoff play.
Yeah, I mean, the Pittsburgh Passion have watched a number of films on Boston, know their unique style, and were able to get in the backfield on that one.
Play fake, and now a pass over to the near side. This is going to be broken up and picked off. How about that?
Looks like that might be Hannah Damon with the interception there on a critical 3rd and 5. Being celebrated by her teammates as she should be as she gets to the sideline.
Allison Cahill wound up trying to throw a little screen over to the right side, and Hannah Damon just read it perfectly, busted it up.
The second career INT for Hannah, so starting off the 2018 season right.
Now the Passion on offense, and they're going to tear right up the middle of the field. It's a 9-yard gain on that first down play by Tara Catone, the young woman we interviewed during the pregame show. How about that? 9 yards on that blast straight up the gut.
It's the kind of yardage you want to see on a first down.
Passion in a bit of a hurry up here. Now we get a penalty flag, and whistles will blow and stop the play dead as Lisa Horton called for the snap. It's going to be a false start against Pittsburgh. see the tempo that Pittsburgh wants to use here, Jennifer, is a rapid tempo, and they're trying to catch Boston flat-footed.
It's a strength that they have. They just have to keep their nerves in check and not false start as they did in that set.
Ooh. Uh-oh, bad snap. Lisa Horton's going to have to go way deep into the backfield inside the 20-yard line to cover that ball at the 18. That one just got away. That was a costly bad snap for Pittsburgh, as now they're in tenuous territory back inside the 20.
Pashing going to have to regroup here, shooting themselves in the foot on the opening kickoff at the penalty, and now a false start and a bad snap. See what Lisa can inspire her crew to do.
Third down, 24 yards to go, and Horton's going to split four receivers out wide. Catone stays in the backfield. She's keeping H-back in, and now send five wide set. Lisa drops back, looks, pumps, throws over the middle, just off the fingertips of Angela Baker, the intended receiver at the 40-yard line.
Angela Baker got the separation she needed from the defender, but the ball just slightly outside of her grasp.
It has been said many, many times that football is a game of field position. Right now, Pittsburgh will try to flip the field inside their own 20-yard line, and the punting down is fourth and long, fourth and 24 to be official. Two receivers back deep in reception formation for Boston. Meister is on to punt, puts her left foot into it, and it wobbles out to the near side, a shanked kick. And it only stays in bounds up to the 38-yard line. And again, Boston's going to have dynamic field position with which to start this second series.
It's a dangerous place to be playing with an offense as strong as the Boston Renegades are, but let's see if the Passion defense can come back and hold.
Pittsburgh did it first time around. Hannah Damon got the interception off of the bubble screen pass thrown by Allison Cahill. Now Cahill back in there, deep behind center in the shotgun. Gets the snap, wraparound handoff, and the run play will go to Pasquale once again, and she'll tiptoe her way for a 2-yard gain.
Tia Montgomery in on that hit. Tia Montgomery, a longtime contributor to the Passion defense corps. Last year she had 46 solo tackles.
Here's Pasquale once again. This is Angelica Pasquale. She'll run straight up the left side of the offensive line. She'll find another yard or two at best. Right now Boston looking at third down and around six. So Pittsburgh holding tough right now. We're early in the ballgame. Second Boston possession. Three receivers to the left. Now she's going to send Pasquale out wide left. Cahill throws again. This one almost picked off, but just broken up by Angela Baker that time, who's playing both ways tonight.
Angela Baker's wanting two of those balls back that hit her fingertips, but that was an excellent job of her jumping the route, reading the quarterback's eyes, and almost coming down.
Brings up fourth down, fourth and six for Boston. The ball sitting just inside the Pittsburgh 35-yard line. Cahill's had a rough start here tonight. One pass picked off, one broken up in the first two series. Now she's going to shuffle her receivers a bit. Slots to both sides. Single back is Pasquale, who goes in motion out wide laterally. Here's Cahill back to pass, looks left, fires left. Has a receiver wide open. That ball is caught over the shoulder, and it's going to be a Boston touchdown. Stephanie Pasquale making the grab and running it in from 34 and a half yards away.
You see a breakdown in the secondary there in the coverage, just letting the wide receiver get behind her, thinking that there was help over top that wasn't there. Easy walk into the end zone for Pasquale.
Now getting set for the point after kick. Emily Beinecke is on the boot, and the holder is Vicky Eddy. Snap placement, kick on its way. It's a line drive kick, but it will travel through the poles, and it is good. And with 11-11 showing on the first quarter clock, Boston strikes first after getting excellent starting position in both of their drives, and they're able to convert. Again, Stephanie Pasquale hauling it in from 34 yards away from Allison Cahill. Pittsburgh Passion Football is brought to you tonight by UPMC Sports Medicine, the official sports medicine provider of the Pittsburgh Passion, by Silver Sport, keeping sports clean, by Post-Acute Medical, providing high-quality post-acute healthcare services, Aid Nation, wake up Pittsburgh and hydrate, by Slippery Rock University, it is Slippery Rock U night tonight here in Pittsburgh, and by Super Donut, number one in nutrition, more protein, less fat. Boston will kick after scoring the touchdown. Cahill to Pasquale, 34 yards. And this kick will just pop up into the air on the bounce taken by Pittsburgh, and the return is on. And this is Gabby O'Neill this time returning the football out to the 49-yard line.
Gabby O'Neill and Tara Katona, formidable ball carriers, both small, shifty, and fast. We saw her tiptoe through the defenders there.
See if Pittsburgh can answer now, Jen. Katona will go into the backfield once again, along with Hannah Damon as the blocking back, or the H-back, if you will. Sharon Vasquez is out wide to the right side, and they have two receivers to the left. First down and 10 for Pittsburgh. Lisa Horton, the longtime quarterback of the Passion, gives it off to Katone. Katone looking for a little bit of a block and got just a sliver of one from Angela Baker. Turns it around the left corner for a, she's going to end up losing a yard, going out of bounds behind the line of scrimmage back at the 47.
Tara trying to do what she can to stretch that play out and then get positive yardage, just couldn't turn the corner fast enough.
Meister is to the left. Baker's in the slot to the right side with Vasquez as the wideout. Again, Damon the H-back, Katone at the tailback spot, gets the handoff. A little stop-and-go move. She slides forward for about a 2 or 3 yard gain up near the midfield stripe. They're going to put her down at the 49-yard line, so give her 2 yards on the pickup.
That was 52 Allie Jennerud that she was able to sidestep around one of Boston's leading tacklers on the season.
Slot comes left side this time for Pittsburgh. Horton shifts the running back. Baker goes in motion right. Lisa sweeping right, stopping, throwing downfield. And that ball's going to be caught for a Pittsburgh first down by Vasquez at the 40-yard line.
Vasquez showing you what a clutch player she is. Her and Lisa have a great chemistry with one another, and she just found open space so that Lisa could deliver the ball.
Gain of 11 on the play, first down and 10, Pittsburgh. Horton trying to get this offense clicking now. Calls for the snap, gives it to Katone off the right side. Katone makes a cut up the middle. 35, down to the 30, look at her put the power on, and she'll pick up 9 on that run play.
Katone makes running up the middle without a fullback look easy, and she's not a big girl herself, but she's got speed, and it's just phenomenal what she's able to do out there.
Horton again gets the snap, finds Katone, she'll sweep left. Turns it upfield, and this time she gets yanked down after a gain of 1. That's going to be a first down for Pittsburgh, though. Move the chains.
Pittsburgh starting to settle down, build off of the momentum they created off of that first down, right into earning their second first down.
Horton again shifts Katone to her right shoulder. And a swing pass right, caught by Baker. Nice little button hook move at the 29, cuts down to the 27-yard line, and she'll pick up three after the catch. Pittsburgh always, Jen, famous for mixing it up offensively, and a new offensive coordinator this year in Mike Melnick.
Mike Melnick is a familiar name here in Western Pennsylvania, usually at the helm of the Mount Lebo football team.
And coach of the Blue Devils. Offensive coordinator here on the staff, led by Teresa Kahn, of course. Here's Catone going straight up the middle. And Catone finds yardage down to the 25. And now the Passion looking at third down, a little bit less than five.
Looks as though 52, Jenneru, was on the tackle there.
Two receivers to the near side left for Horton. She'll keep it on the ground. Catone will run it, looking for a block, turns it upfield, and is run to the boundary line. Good defensive play by Mocha Torres that time for Boston. A little bit of a question for Pittsburgh here, but I think they're going to answer it by keeping the offense on the field. Fourth down and four. See what they come up with. Slots to both sides. Crystal Kozo comes in to play offense now. Sweeps to the right. Lisa Horton flings one downfield. The ball is complete to the 10-yard line. Another Pittsburgh first down.
And that is Angela Baker reeling in the catch from the pass from Lisa Horton as they're knocking on the door of the end zone.
Ball sitting just outside the 11-yard line. First down and 10, Pittsburgh. .644 to go, clock winding. We're in the first quarter of play. Boston is up 7-0. Play fake. And an option pitch to Baker, who was coming from the left side to the right. And this play got blown up by Boston. They read it. It's going to be a loss of a yard or two. And again, in on the tackle that time, leading the way, was Allie Genero.
Looks like you have Kia Foster coming in to give Tara Catone a spell.
Second down and 11 now for Pittsburgh. Horton's going to fire one out to the left side. A little bubble screen, and that one thrown a little shy. Crystal Kozo was trying to make that catch behind the blocks of Meister and Baker, but the pass just didn't get there, and she had to go down to her knee to try to make the catch. Third down and 11 now for Pittsburgh. Under 6 minutes to go, first quarter of play. Chris Shublin, along with Jen Cairns, on the call here, Passion Television tonight. Horton will bring Baker closer into the backfield this time with Foster running the tailback position. There's Baker going out in motion right. Horton steps up, chucks one, end zone. Baker over the shoulder! Touchdown, Pittsburgh!
Baker making that very difficult acrobatic catch look easy, keeping her eye on the ball, reeling it in for a Pittsburgh Passion touchdown.
That was pretty. Angela Baker with an acrobatic over-the-shoulder twisting catch at the back right pylon of the end zone from the quarterback's view.
Not only was it pretty, it was special. That is her 40th career Passion touchdown.
How about that? Kirsten Green is on to kick. Snap is true. Kick is on its way. Line drive, tall enough to get over the crossbar. And we have a tie ball game at 7-0. How about that, Jen?
Pretty impressive. You know, you could come out and be deflated after the way Boston moved the ball to score that first touchdown against the Passion, but they came out and smacked him in the mouth right back, Chris.
Ties Well, once Pittsburgh got into that silver sports silver zone, they had ideas of cashing in. That's exactly what they did. And I'll tell you what, they worked hard to bust through that Boston defense. That stout Boston defense was trying to hold them, but Lisa Horton just found Angela Baker deep in that end zone and delivered it perfectly.
Lisa doing what Lisa does, right?
Really. And always has done. Here's Green with a run-up. This one will be taken by Bonds, looking for an opening. Dives up the middle and grinds out a return to the 42-yard line.
Tackled by 23.
In the stop that time for Pittsburgh was Ellison Malarski out of Slippery Rock University. It is Slippery Rock night here tonight, isn't it?
It is. Another alum making them proud.
Boston will have the football first down and 10 at its own 42-yard line.
Yeah, and we failed to mention that that connection between Lisa Horton and Angela Baker was a rock-to-rock alum connection there.
And that rocket landed perfectly, didn't it?
It did.
Here is a swing pass out to the left side, caught by Pascal once again. And Pascal, as she turned the corner, coming deep out of the backfield, gets back to the line of scrimmage, and that is all. Good coverage again by the Pittsburgh Passion on defense. Santana Ramsey was there right on the spot. Triangle set to the left this time for Boston. Allison Cahill in at quarterback, has a single receiver over to the right side and Beinecke. Now Pascal comes out of the backfield to the right. Cahill winds up, throws to nobody that time. And again, closest receiver was Beinecke over in the right side flat. But she was covered by two Passion defenders.
Yeah, and it looks like Kozo and Smith might have bumped into each other and knocked themselves down. One of them would have been in better position to catch that overthrown ball.
It'll be third down and 10 now for Boston. Cahill. Rushed. Steps up and won't survive. She's sacked. Tremendous pressure by Pittsburgh.
Looks like Zubo in on the tackle and Kelsey Edmonds.
Kelsey Edmonds, a defensive end out of Pittsburgh, attended Utica College. And
Kim Zabovic,
the defensive end out of Bell Vernon, went to WNJ. And they had a little quarterback sandwich in that backfield, and it's fourth down and 14. Boston to punt. Snap goes crazy. Beckham has to go find it, and by the time she gets it upfield, she'll just get a roller inside of Pittsburgh territory to the 46-yard line. Now we're going to get a late flag well after the punt. Not sure if something was said, something was done, but that flag came way after the play had ended.
Reading the body language of some of the Passion players, wondering if it was one of our ladies that got called for saying something. It is on us.
A 5-yard mark off against Pittsburgh.
I think it was a substitution penalty that I saw the signal for. Which is kind of weird because it was like between plays.
Mm-hmm.
Pittsburgh has it offensively again. Ball sitting at the 41-yard line after that five-yard penalty. There goes Angela Baker streaking across the set in motion right. Here's the handoff. Tara Cattell with a quick opener and another nine-yard burst straight up the gut.
She hits that hole with such power and speed. She's at least 3 yards in before they realize that she's even got the ball.
Well, officially give her 8 on that one. It's second down and 2. Her knee touchdown at the 49-yard line, and she's going to drive the middle once again. This time, she'll get past the front marker, and that will be a Pittsburgh first down at the Boston 49.
She earned the first down, but she was met and brought down by 36 Charlene Casey of the Renegades.
3.5 minutes left here in the first quarter of play. It's Pittsburgh 7, Boston 7. Always a great game between these two clubs. Blitz coming. Horton's going to hand off through it. And the run play will come to the left, and Pittsburgh will gain yardage down to the 45-yard line. And it's Cattone once again carrying the mail for 4. Deanna Walsh came in there and brought her down. High snap, Horton contains, and now Cattone will run. Tara runs it down to around the 41-yard line. She'll pick up about 4 or 5 more. It's going to be 3rd down and 2 for Pittsburgh now.
And she's usually gaining a yard after she makes contact. If you watch her as a ball carrier, she'll dip that shoulder and power those strong legs through.
Yeah, she talked to us before the game started tonight, Jen, and told us how good it feels to be healthy again, fully healthy again, because she had a breakout campaign about 2 or 3 years ago, mm-hmm. and then had some health issues and injury issues, and fortunately she's back in full stead. And now a little misconnection there as Cattone and Horton didn't make the connection, and Lisa Horton had to dive on top of the football and recover it. The Passion will lose a couple on this one. And now they're looking at 4th down and 3.
Well, Lisa had to go after another high snap, did a great mm-hmm. job reeling it in, but then couldn't get the handoff to Cattone. We've got to work on getting those snaps down where they need to be.
See if Lisa wants to throw downfield. She's pointing into the secondary as if she's trying to goad Boston into a passing set. Horton looking to the sideline, now calling Baker into motion. Gonna have to get that snap. And again, it goes over her head. And she can't cover it this time, and Boston will find it, or will they? Ball still being fought for. Back at the 36-yard line, and Boston has recovered. Ending up with the football for the Renegades was Jessica Penta. She gets the recovery, but snaps have been an issue here in the early going for Pittsburgh.
They have. Boston has been getting a lot of help from Pittsburgh, whether through penalties, whether through muff snaps. Pittsburgh's got to buckle down.
Boston will take over with a 1:32 left here in the first period of play. All tied up at 7. The Renegades with fine field position. This is the 3rd time in this first quarter that they've started around the 35-yard line. Started at the 35, the 38, now the 36. And getting decked is Angelica Pascual trying to run around that left side. Santana Ramsey again coming out of the secondary.
Yeah, Santana Ramsey is ultimately the one who brought the ball carrier down, but it was Caitlin Niedermeyer that met her in the backfield, held her up until the cavalry arrived.
3 receivers to the left side for Boston. 2nd down and 10. Single wide out right is Beinecke. Cahill calling for the snap. Play fake. Pump fake. Tries to run, and she's going to be sacked. And there she goes, number 77 for Pittsburgh, Caitlin Niedermeyer out of Brentwood High School. And she gets to bag a quarterback this time around. It brings up 3rd down and long.
Caitlin was involved in the prior play, getting in the backfield, slowing the ball carrier down again in the backfield in this play, this time sacking the quarterback.
Third down, 14 yards to go now for Boston after the loss with a sack back to the 40-yard line. Pascal in motion, laterally to the left. Cahill stands tall and now is chased again. Cahill flings one downfield and that ball comes off the hands of the intended receiver and is dropped over on that far side.
She was being chased in the backfield by number 77, Niedermeyer again, who on that previous play earned her 12th career sack, looking for her 13th.
Stephanie Pascal, who caught that first touchdown of the game by Boston, dropped that ball as we've come to the end of the first quarter of play here at Joseph P. DeMichiela Stadium in Imperial. Chris Shublin, Jan Cairns on the call. Passion 7, Boston 7. This is Pittsburgh Passion Television. Seven ball game, Pittsburgh and Boston. We flip sides of the field, and it is fourth down and 14. Boston will keep the offense out there. Cahill trying to get something going. Big rush is on. Cahill throws downfield, receiver wide open, and keeps both feet in bounds as Emily Beinecke makes the catch just beyond the front stick, and Boston is able to move the chains to get the first down.
On the coverage on that side, looks like it's number 40, Crystal Kozo, on Beinecke, who is Cahill's favorite target. She's got 244 yards in just two games this season, receiving.
First down and 10 now for Boston. Cahill with a low snap, able to pick it up and hand it off to Angelica Pascal, and she is drilled into the turf. And that was a hard takedown that time for Pittsburgh by Mashantia Smith. Second down after no gain. Cahill, play fake, throws over the middle. This one is caught inside the 5-yard line by Beinecke once again out of Cambridge, Mass. Now Boston in the hurry up, trying to catch Pittsburgh flat-footed. Ball at the 5, first and goal from there. Now we get a penalty, and we're going to get a false start call. The official pointing at Beinecke, the receiver over on the far side, who might have moved after everybody else was set. That brings up first down and goal from the 10. And also, Jen, what that does is slow down Boston's pace,
which seemed to be working. The hurry-up was working for them against this defense who wasn't able to set and adjust.
Pittsburgh showing blitz. Cahill looks a little antsy back there. Eyeing up the defense, gets the snap, and she'll give it, and the run will go inside the 5 by Pascal. She'll get it down to the 4. Second down and goal to go for Boston. Play fake, Cahill rolling right. Cahill chased, throws, and it goes incomplete. Beinecke, the intended receiver, and that pass broken up over at the front pylon. Crystal Kozo was there.
Great defensive play, just being patient, following the wide receiver. Agility for agility, breaking it up just as the ball was delivered.
Boston changing up personnel. Let's see if they try to go to a run game now. Third down and goal from the 4-yard line. Cahill now has Jennero in the backfield with her as a blocker.
Deep run by Bonds into the backfield. They're going to give it to Genro, and she'll run it to the left. Still no whistle. Still no stop. Finally, the officials will blow the whistle and say she's down shy of the goal line. Inside the one. Genro with a power run off the left side. Now Boston hurries up and lines up. It's fourth down and goal to go from inside the one-yard line.
Just trying to benefit from Genro's pure size. He's typically a linebacker.
Cahill, drop the ball! It's on the floor. Boston is saying it's in the end zone. The officials haven't made a signal yet.
But they can't fumble forward into the end zone.
The officials still chatting about it. I think the officials are saying what you're thinking. You cannot fumble the ball forward and score. So they had five players lined up in the backfield in an illegal formation against Boston. And they're going to push the ball out beyond the five-yard line. Replay the down. Fourth down and goal from 5.5 yards away. I know Pittsburgh caught a break there, but so did Boston.
So they did Boston, the ball. Yeah, and you know, too bad a black jersey didn't just happen to be able to scoop that in. Defense looking to pull strength from the crowd and Passion, noise.
Passion fans getting loud, loving it. Cahill in the gun. Pascal in motion right, Cahill looking to the post, throws! Touchdown Boston, hauling it in was Beneke from 5.5 yards away.
Beneke just getting a last minute step there on Crystal Kozo to be able to pull in the ball for the second touchdown of the day for the Renegades.
Goodman is on to kick. Placement is there. Kick is up into the air, end over end, and it is good. And Boston takes its second lead of the ball game. The Renegades 14 and Pittsburgh 7. Tonight's game is being presented by UPMC Sports Medicine, the official sports medicine provider of the Pittsburgh Passion. By Silver Sport, keeping sports clean. Post-acute medical, providing high-quality post-acute healthcare services. By Aid Nation, wake up Pittsburgh and hydrate. By Slippery Rock University of Pennsylvania, tonight is Slippery Rock U Night here with the Pittsburgh Passion. And, of course, by Super Donut, number one in nutrition, more protein, less fat.
Well, the second quarter starting off much like the first. Boston getting some good field position, capitalizing on it, finding the end zone. Let's see if Pittsburgh can respond.
Emily Beneke making some tough catches. Cahill's been hassled tonight by Pittsburgh, Jen, but she's been able to stand her ground in this last series for the most part.
When she was in trouble last week against DC, she was looking for Beneke, and it seems like she's doing the same this week against Pittsburgh.
Brooke Goodman to kick from the 35-yard line. 14-7, Boston in the lead over Pittsburgh with 11:48 to go here in the second period. Boy, she barely touched the ball, and it didn't go 10 yards. Pittsburgh does fall on top of it. Passion able to take over. Deep in Boston's territory right now, and Santana Ramsey was able to run up on that ball and cover it. Boston looked like he was going to go for the onside kick, but it appeared that Goodman actually stepped and popped the ball.
Yeah, It's a strategy that they employed last week against DC that worked for them, and they were hoping to catch the Passion off guard. She just unfortunately didn't get off her foot correctly. Nice break for the Passion.
Slots to both sides now as Lisa Horton and the Passion offense come back out to play some ball. First down and 10. Catone, the running back, slips one tackle, couldn't slip the second one as she's able to find a couple of yards on the run play. In tandem, Allie Genero and Jessica Cabrera making the stop for Boston. Second down, 8 yards to go after a gain of 2. Horton calling for the play from the bench. Again, slots to both sides for Pittsburgh. Horton, short drop. Throws downfield, and that ball just off the fingertips, and it looked like Crystal Kozo was over there running the outs at the 20. It's going to bring up third down and 8 yards to go now for Pittsburgh. Kozo and Meister joined by Vasquez over on the left side. Baker by herself on the right. Boston showing blitz. And Horton now checking with the sideline. Lisa floats one. Baker on a comebacker sliding, and they're going to call that incomplete. I thought Angela might have been able to get under that ball, but they're going to rule that it was not caught at the 31-yard line. It'll go as an incompletion. Would have been a first down for Pittsburgh, though.
They seem to have the snaps under control this series. The hope was that Angela could get just underneath that one. I think she did her best acting job after on the ground, but the refs weren't buying it.
Fourth down and 8 now for Pittsburgh. Trailing by a touchdown. Baker slides in front of the quarterback in motion left. Horton rolls left, fires downfield. Kozo over the shoulder, 20, 15. Crystal to the sideline, touchdown Pittsburgh.
Very nice yards after the catch. Able to juke the defender to find her way to the end zone to tie this game up.
Crystal Kozo playing both sides of the football again tonight. And West Allegheny, her alma mater, she is from Imperial. She scores one home. Now the Passion a point away from tying this up. They need this kick. Kirsten Green will have to boot this one from the 15-yard line. This will be a 25-yard kick. Ebony Montgomery, the holder, high snap, brought it down, and the kick is going to be blocked. Boston trying to scramble after the ball, and there will be no return, but Boston maintains a one-point lead, 14-13, with 10 minutes, 20 seconds left in the first half.
Well, we know how this game goes, Chris. A one-point differential on a blocked PAT is something that could haunt the Passion through the rest of this game. Crystal Kozo, though, on the positive side, that's her fourth career touchdown.
And a pretty touchdown it was, too. The run after the catch was dramatic.
You know, that's what being a DB can equip you with. You understand what they're trained to do and how to just maybe throw that one move that's going to distract them. That's exactly what she did, and she was able to just walk clear into the end zone after that.
Now Green will try to kick from the 35-yard line. Pittsburgh still on the short end of the score here, 14-13 after that touchdown from Horton to Kozo. Green will kick.
Green gets under this one. And the return is on. That's Lauren Young bringing the ball back to the near side. And Young has her feet taken out from under her by Rebecca Ergood.
Actually think it was 26 for the Pittsburgh Passion. Gabby O'Neill that got there with speed and was able to make the shoestring tackle.
All right, let's give credit where credit's due. First down and 10 now. Boston has the football at its own 39-yard line. 10:14 to go here in the second quarter of play. Allison Cahill went to Princeton University. She is from Boston. She's the quarterback of the Renegades under head coach John Johnson. She'll roll to the right. Still has time. Now she decides to tuck and get what she can, and just a short gain after running up to that stick. Anna Damon was able to pressure her out of bounds. She'll pick up two.
Kim Zabobic got in the backfield, was able to chase Cahill out of the pocket. As Cahill looked down the field and saw her wide receivers covered, she attempted to utilize that speed to get what she could on the play.
Cahill has three receivers in a triangle set to the right. Instead, she'll give it off on the ground. Pasquale running to the left. Cuts it back up the middle, and Pasquale finally gets roped up and dragged down on the play. Again for Pittsburgh, it's Santana Ramsey. That's a 7-yard pickup, third down and one. Pasquale, stop and go move. Niedermeyer had her around the legs and finally dragged her down after two other Passion players hit her. T.M. Montgomery was the first one to nail her and slow her down, so Niedermeyer was able to make the stop.
That's a 1-2 punch that has been very successful for the Pittsburgh Passion, with Niedermeyer getting in the backfield and usually T.M. Montgomery finishing them off, and this time it was the reverse.
Cahill has three to the right once again. Single running back off her right shoulder. That is Pasquale. Single receiver to the left is Bonds. Now Pasquale repositions to the left side. Runs laterally.
Bold move on fourth and two in the midfield.
Rush coming. Reverses field, fires. And that ball is going to be batted out of the sky. Incomplete. A great defensive play by Pittsburgh once again.
I believe that was 49. Shantia Smith went up for the ball and just tipped it right out of the receiver's range of opportunity.
Second great defensive play by Smith here tonight.
And she was hyped up after that play, as she should be. You know, it was pretty gutsy of Boston to do that on fourth and two in the field position that they are. Passion defense, not to be disrespected like that.
Wonder how good she is at volleyball, because that was one whale of a spike.
It was.
Now Pittsburgh takes over. And the Passion have the football inside of Boston territory. First down and 10 from the 47-yard line. Lisa Horton, the longtime Pittsburgh veteran, one of the most prolific passers in the history of women's football nationally, in at quarterback. 8:40 left, second quarter. Horton getting a little call from the sideline, and now she's going to call her own number, and she'll run with the football. 40, 35, 30, and Lisa's run out of bounds on the near sideline. You never know what's coming when Lisa Horton is quarterbacking your football team, and Vicky Eddy was able to just belt her in the shoulder blades to knock her out.
It was an incredible read and pickup by Lisa Horton, because Allie Jennerud was showing blitz the whole time, backed off, showed as soon as she left her post, she just ran where Jennerud was and found green space, and she did what she does with her legs. She's that triple threat we've talked about for years.
Now the ball is sitting, Jan, at the 29-yard line. Pittsburgh with a first down and 10. Here's Horton. Looks downfield, streaking receiver off of the left side. That's going to be caught, and another Pittsburgh Passion touchdown, and Pittsburgh has reclaimed the lead.
Familiar combination. That was a pass to Kozo again, who was able to shed her defender. Has great hands, reels it in, finds her way to the end zone for the second time today.
This one from 29 yards away. And Pittsburgh is now up 19-14. Now keep in mind they had the last extra point blocked after a penalty moved it back to the 15. The low line drive kick was blocked into the line, so let's see if they'll go for two, and it looks like they will. Motion by Vasquez to the set. Here's Horton rolling right, pumping, throwing end zone. Baker makes the catch, and it's good for the two-point conversion. 21-14 Pittsburgh with 7:56 left in the second.
I think Pittsburgh was a little bit hyped up there with Boston going for it fourth down in the middle of the field, and certainly made them pay for that choice.
Kick will travel to the 30-yard line. And a good return out to the 45 by the Renegades. And it was Bonds bringing the back once again. Boston will have it at the Pittsburgh 45-yard line. First down and 10 with 7:47 left here in the first half of play. Passion on top again, 21-14. Cahill gives it to Pasquale, and she'll run it straight up the gut. And the tackle will be made after a gain up the middle. That's Hannah Damon making the stop after about a 3-yard pickup. Make it a 2-yard run. Second down and 8. Ball sitting at the 47-yard line. Pasquale once again, this time cuts over to the right side, turns it upfield. And a bevy of black and gold Pittsburgh Passion defenders come in and swat her down.
Pasquale showing a great amount of field awareness and patience there as she waited to see her blocks form in front of her, skirted her way through behind them.
Third down and 1 now for Boston at the Pittsburgh 46. Here's Cahill, looping one down the right side, and again a drop pass at around the 25-yard line. Oh, that could have been absolutely deadly for Pittsburgh. That was Catherine Tylander, the wide receiver out of Harvard, trying to look up over her shoulder and bring that one down, but she did not make the catch, and now Boston is looking at fourth down and 1. That's one Tylander would want back. Cahill instead will give off. Pasquale hit in the backfield, and the Passion may have been able to stop her before she got back much further past that line of scrimmage, and they did.
Turnover,
they stopped
down.
Her. You know, Jen, I know coaches guard against arm tackling, but that one worked.
That one did work.
Pittsburgh takes over on downs, first down and 10. Passion with the football at their own 46-yard line.
Again, dangerous to give this high-octane Passion offense led by Leeson Horton such good field position to start with.
Meister goes out wide to the left side. She'll be a flanker. Veronica Burris is the tight end on the left. Slot right. Baker in that slot goes in motion left. Here's Catone with a run play to the left side. A little stop and go move, and Catone puts her head down and drives forward.
Sorts of yellow flags flying there.
That's okay.
Face mask call against Boston's Kareem Shoham.
5 and 15, right? Big fight play. 15.
No, yeah. And this is going to be the big one. Down to the 34-yard line. First down and 10 for Pittsburgh with 6.5 left here in the first half of play. 21-14. The Passion in the lead over the Boston Renegades. Horton fakes the handoff. And she is upended and it cracked down inside the 30 at around the 27-yard line. She actually tried to jump through the tackle of Brianna Gallo, and Gallo was able to hang on.
Gallo is able to catch her and then just slam her to the ground. But not after Lisa made some significant strides in yardage for the Pittsburgh Passion.
Second down, a little more than two for Pittsburgh. They have it at the Boston, 27.5. Here's Catone. And again, a little stutter step move through that line. It's able to buy her some time, and she is able to drive through for a 4-yard gain and a first down for Pittsburgh to the Boston 23-yard line.
She's certain making her mother, grandmother, and little sister who are in the crowd tonight very proud.
First down and 10, Pittsburgh. Horton digs in. In the pistol. Catone again. And Catone with just a couple. Good effort defensively that time by Boston to bring her down. Charlene Casey was there, the linebacker. Second down, 9 yards to go, and now Horton will flood the left side with receivers. Catone will run the ball to the left side, and Catone able to turn the corner and take the football all the way down to the 15. Spotter at the 16-yard line, and Pittsburgh is looking at third down and a little bit more than three. Now the receivers are in a four spread. Tia Foster comes in to play running back. And they fake the handoff to Foster, and Horton got clipped down as she tried to drive it straight up the middle that time, and a good defensive play by Boston, able to knock her down. Loss of a couple of yards, fourth down and 5 now for Pittsburgh. The ball sitting in the Silver Sports Silver Zone at the 19. Motion across the set by Kozo. Horton will roll to the right, pump. Now delivered down to the end zone. And this one is
Vasquez wrestling away from the defenders. Wow. Two Passion receivers went up for that ball and two Boston defenders, and she just wrestled it out of all three of their arms and came down.
Sharon Vasquez, the longtime Pittsburgh veteran, ripping that one out of the sky. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. 27-14, Passion in the lead, going for the PAT with 3:06 left.
That is Sharon's 11th career offensive touchdown. We know she's had some pick sixes in her career with the Pittsburgh Passion too, but that's her 11th offensively. Way to go.
Green is on the kick, puts it up into the air, it's end over end, it's good, and the Passion have doubled up Boston, 28-14 with 3:06 left in the half.
Again, dangerous to give this Passion offense. It's got so many weapons, good field position. You would think Boston would punt the next time they're fourth in the middle of the field.
A Pittsburgh had several questions coming into the ballgame about how they would match up with a team that ended up in the national championship game a year ago, and I think they've really acquitted themselves well here in this first half, despite some jitters in that first quarter where we saw some bad snaps, but they've gotten that under control apparently now, Jen.
Well, that's the true, you know, testament to the mental toughness of having some veterans on your team that say there are going to be ups and downs in this game. There have always been when we play this team, and we're going to make mistakes, they're going to make mistakes. We just have to learn from them and mitigate them, and they seem to have, you know, luckily shaken those off and been able to put some great offensive drives together.
Green will kick. Here's her run up. Sails it over to the right side to Bonds off the bounce at the 25. Collects it, 30. Upfield along the hash mark, 35-40. And a flag coming from the far side from her return vantage. And she'll bring it back to the 41-yard line. Deanna Walsh called for a block in the back on the return for Boston. So they'll mark that off against the Renegades here. And Boston's offense will start again. Find themselves down by two touchdowns now to Pittsburgh. So they've got to be talking to themselves over there.
Yeah, and they're going to want to score before the half ends because, remember, passion deferred on the coin toss, and they get the ball coming out third quarter.
First down and 10 now for the Renegades. Cahill gives off, run right, pass ball. She'll try to turn that corner and does so over the 30, up close to the 35. And she's run to the boundary line. They're going to say she stepped out just shy of the 34-yard line.
Beinecke throwing a really nice seal block over there on the outside corner that allowed Pasquale to get to the edge.
Pickup of 6, second down and 4 now for Boston. Cahill with two protectors. Pittsburgh showing blitz and now motion out to the left side by Stephanie Pasquale, who has a touchdown catch in this game. There's Angelica Pasquale turning over the right side, and she gets knocked down after maybe a 1-yard pickup. Niedermeyer with some help over there on that far side of play. McCray off that defensive tackle spot also in there. Third down and 2 now for Boston. It's Cahill, play fake, throws one up as she's hit. Downfield it goes, Beneke making the catch over her head and dragging the ball down at the 39-yard line. She was in a little bit of a hand fight with Crystal Kozo for that ball, but Beneke making the nice catch. Now Boston in the hurry up. They don't even have the chain set yet. Now a penalty flag flies as Pasquale gets the handoff and runs to the left. And let's see, we're gonna have some stuff being determined here by the officials. Chain crew hadn't caught up with it yet. Second such call for 5 players in the backfield tonight against Boston.
You know, it's happened every time they've tried to go into this hurry up.
95 seconds left here in the first half. 28-14, Pittsburgh in the lead. Boston trying to hurry downfield to get a score before they have to go into the locker room. First down and 15 after the penalty. Pasquale goes out wide, laterally run into the backfield. Cahill steps up, throws. Beneke makes the catch and gets drilled as she does so by Hannah Damon. They'll pick up about 4 on the pass play, and Damon was right there and read it nicely. Second down and 11. Cahill. Winds up, throws long, has Beneke downfield over the shoulder grab. This is going to be a touchdown for Boston from 41 yards away.
Cahill recognizing the mismatch that was going on over there on the right side. Beneke doing a little stop and go.
Well, Pittsburgh was called for offside, so naturally Boston is going to decline that penalty and the touchdown will stand. Pretty play, though. Really, what Pittsburgh didn't want to have happen was to let Boston get in the end zone before halftime here. Now they've made it a one-touchdown game as they bring their kicker, Brooke Goodman, out. The kick bangs through good. A 7-point game again. Pittsburgh 28, Boston 21, 41 ticks left on the first half clock. We expected a good game, a great game, really, when you get down to it, between Boston and Pittsburgh tonight. We're seeing one, and we still have another half of football, plus 41 more ticks left on this half.
That's right. You know, they're going shootout.
There's the onside kick out of the huddle, out of the scrum. Mm-hmm. Hannah Damon able to recover at the 50-yard line and take some punishment with it as well. Pittsburgh has it, 41 seconds left, half the field to work with.
Both these teams play aggressive, so don't doubt for 1 second that Lisa Horton's not looking for the end zone on every play of the last 41 seconds of the half.
Pittsburgh will huddle up on the near side before they take the field for the final few seconds. Jana Meister will trot over to the far side left. She'll be the wide receiver. Crystal Kozo will go over to the slot. To the right side, Angela Baker with Sharon Vasquez. The double slot formation for Lisa Horton on first down and 10 from the 50. Catone, the single running back. Eyeballs over the right shoulder to the sideline to change up the call. Horton refocuses. Marks the count. Short drop, fires out left side, and a catch at the knees.
Gonna get to the line quickly. Timeout.
Now timeout is going to be called. Pittsburgh calls its first timeout. That gives us time to remind you tonight's game is being presented here on Passion Television by UPMC Sports Medicine, the official sports medicine provider of the Pittsburgh Passion, by Silver Sport, keeping sports clean, by Post-Acute Medical, providing high-quality post-acute healthcare services, Aid Nation, wake up Pittsburgh and hydrate, by Super Donut, number one in nutrition, more protein and less fat, and tonight is Slippery Rock University night here at the Passion Home Stadium in the West Hills. Passion got five on that first down play, Jen. Second down and five, but right now with 30 seconds left here, they're going to need more than five-yard chunks at a time.
And Lisa's going to be looking for that. You know, she's always looking downfield for the big play, normally looking at Vasquez.
Here comes Lisa Horton rolling right. Getting a nice block, throwing out right side, caught! Sharon Vasquez making the catch, stepping out to conserve time at the 29-yard line, and with 24 seconds left, or I should say the 34-yard line, not the 29, but the 34-yard line, that's where Pittsburgh has it first and 10.
Vasquez showing her toughness there as a former DB, you know, decleating the defender, Sammy Bloom, to create that space, make the easy catch and get out of bounds to save the clock.
Another first down for Pittsburgh. Horton calling for the ball, getting it. Steps up. Chased out. Directing traffic. Sidearm throw, it's gonna be incomplete. There should be a flag now for interference or some contact. But we're not gonna get one. Kozo was down that sideline trying to spring loose. She and the defensive back collided.
Didn't look like incidental contact to me, but no. I'm not wearing the stripes.
Apparently I was when I just called that.
Second down and 10 now for Pittsburgh, 13 seconds left, that's it. A one touchdown lead for Pittsburgh, 28-21 over Boston. As we head to halftime. We hear Boston's cheering section yelling defense right now. They know Pittsburgh's on the attack. Pittsburgh wants a timeout before it calls for the snap.
Give a shout out to the Passion Drumline, keeping us entertained on this timeout.
Drumline jamming it up tonight. Fans are crowded in here. They're all bundled up, and you know, we're finally starting to get some spring type of weather here, although it's still chilly tonight, but a lot of folks braving the elements here tonight, if you can call them elements. Finally, the temperature's starting to get a little more spring-like here in Pittsburgh, but a lot of black and gold in the stands here tonight. Let's see if we can put some black and gold in the end zone here. Here's Horton with a rollout to the right, pumps, sets, wings one downfield, and just off the fingertips of Angela Baker, the intended receiver, running to the near side pylon. 4 seconds left in the half.
Like we lost 2 seconds there before they stopped the clock. But regardless, one play left.
Mm-hmm. One play means one strike for the end zone. You can't come up shy. And we know that Lisa Horton can get it there. How many times have we seen it?
Numerous times over the last 16 years for sure.
Kozo in motion, bringing three receivers to the right side. Horton pumps. She's going to throw left. And this one just off the fingertips of the intended receiver over to the left side. I believe that's Meister over there. And the horn sounds, and we've come to the end of the first half. I'll play an exciting football game going on here tonight at Women's Professional Football. Pittsburgh Passion lead the Boston Renegades 28-21. Your thoughts?
Exciting end there to the half. You know, those two passes were beautiful balls by Lisa Horton just off the fingertips of the receivers. You know, this is the kind of back and forth that we've seen. The positive thing being that the mistakes and the Passion seem to be making early have, you know, gone by the wayside, so they can come out strong in the second half of the ball and hopefully jam it down Boston's throat.
All right, we'll see if they can do just that. Our halftime report when we come back is provided by Post Acute Medical, providing high quality post acute health care services. We'll have that for you coming up next. Again, at the half, it's the Pittsburgh Passion 28 and the Boston Renegades 21 here on the Pittsburgh Passion Television Network. Pittsburgh with a 28-21 lead over Boston, and Pittsburgh will receive the second half kickoff after deferring from the coin toss at the start of the ball game, and Boston immediately goes back to the onside kick. Passion say they've recovered, and they apparently have at the 49-yard line. And the last lady out of that pile is Meister. Jana Meister, the defensive back out of Iowa Wesleyan and Chicago, Illinois, able to recover that one, and she took a crack down at the bottom of that pile.
Yeah, you know, I was holding my breath because it was a pile up there trying to hope that a black and gold jersey came out with it. But let's give you some first-half statistics for Lisa Horton, who's about to take under center again. She's got 147 yards in the first half. Angela Baker has 3 receptions for 29 yards and a touchdown, and we'll get more to you after this play.
Horton on first down, just inside of Boston territory at the 49 and a half. Tara Catone is the running back behind her, 2 slots, 1 to each side, and Catone now shifts. Blitz coming. Horton feels it, reads it, rolls left, throws left, downfield, and a rollover catch made as Kozo comes up with the ball once again. And this down to the 34-yard line. So a 15-yard reception on the pass play from Horton to Kozo. Horton sends 3 to the right side wide this time. Run play. Straight up the middle it goes. Tara Catone carrying it down to the 32, close to the 31-yard line. Catone among the players for the Pittsburgh Passion celebrating Slippery Rock University night tonight. Lisa Horton is 1. Ellison Malarski another. Julie Ayanta also from Slippery Rock, and we'll get a few others in there as the night rolls on. Now here's a run play straight up the gut. Look at Lisa Horton. She'll dig all the way down inside the 15-yard line, and the Passion are back in the Silver Sports Silver Zone as they have it cranked up here at the start of the third period.
Horton seeing an opportunity and seizing on it as she does, getting the first down for the Pittsburgh Passion. Still would love to see you cradle that ball, Lisa, but don't give us heart attacks up here.
2 receivers in the slot to the left side this time. Single wide out is Vasquez to the right. Horton gives it to Catone, and I'm not sure if she had it cleanly or not. And Catone just gets back to the line of scrimmage, and that's all.
In the first half, Tara Catone carried the ball 16 times for 57 yards, getting it done for the Passion.
Stephanie Jeffers stepped up and stuffed her that time at the line of scrimmage. It's second down a little more than 10 for Pittsburgh. Ball shy of the 16-yard line. Horton, again controlling a high snap, running the option to the left side. Pitches out late. Catone gets it and gets a couple of extra yards. And here comes a flag for a late hit, apparently, over on that sideline.
Looking like the late hit might be on Jenneroo.
And now another flag here, Jen. Possibly something said after the initial penalty.
Stakes are high, it's getting chippy, but that's where you've got to have your emotions under control.
All right, so General not only got the penalty for the late hit as we thought, but apparently she had something to say to the officials after that, and unsportsmanlike conduct call against her first of the game, and they keep track of those.
They do.
So now it is first down and goal in the Silver Sports Silver Zone. Pittsburgh with it at the 4-yard line. Here is Horton faking the handoff to Catone. She pulled it back out, tried to run it herself, and got drilled at the 1. You mentioned the stakes getting higher and the game getting chippier. Two receivers right in Vasquez, the wide out, and the slot flanker is Baker. Horton to Catone, strings it out left, and now tries to cut up field and gets to about the 3-yard line. Boston tightening up right now, and Pittsburgh making that mistake. A costly error driving them back beyond the 5-yard line on that last play. Now they have a third down and goal to go from the 3.
We talked about how they were minimizing, doing a good job of minimizing the costly mistakes as the second half came to a close. Hoping that that's the last of those here in the third quarter.
4 receivers back in now, Jennifer. And again, a miscue by Pittsburgh. And a false start, 2nd 1 in this set.
Lisa's got to take control, calm her O-line down.
5-yard penalty will push the ball back to the 8-yard line. It's 3rd down and goal from there. These are mistakes that are very costly, particularly against a very stout ball club like the Boston Renegades.
Absolutely, Chris.
Pittsburgh with 3 wide to the left, 1 to the right. Horton looking left, sending one. End zone off the hands, incomplete.
Looks like it was Sharon Vasquez, the intended receiver that time.
She may have been shaken up on the play as well. Maybe cramping up. So the officials will call a stop and cheer for an apparent injury to Sharon Vasquez. As I said, it looks like she's cramping up over there in the far corner of the end zone. With 9:29 left here in the third period of play, with the Passion leading by a touchdown, 28-21 over the Boston Renegades.
Do you find it easier to see or harder to see with this light on? Is it harder hand? Can we turn it off? It's harder to see. I just see our reflections more than anything. Yeah.
That's better.
That's better, yeah.
Thanks.
I was just staring at ourselves. I'm like, I can't see. Thanks, Nate.
Windex next week, too. Another timeout for the injury to Sharon Vasquez. The training staff from UPMC Sports Medicine, Nancy Martin and her great crew, making sure Sharon's okay. It appeared that she had been cramping up, and now Pittsburgh on 4th down will go for a field goal attempt here. This will be a 25-yard attempt, and we've got a little movement on the line of scrimmage before the kick is even pulled off, and it's going to be a false start against Kim Zabovic is the call. 98 is whistled. We also saw Stephanie Jeffers jump over the line of scrimmage for Boston, but she did so cleanly. But now that's cost Pittsburgh another 5 yards. So now we're looking at a 30-yard field goal attempt. Kicker is Kirsten Green out of Asheville, New York, and Panama Central High School. Here's the kick. It's on its way. It's end over end. It's nice. Got the distance. It's good.
That is her first career field goal attempt, and what one to make in a critical game, in a critical time against the Boston Renegades. Great job, Green.
A 30-yard field goal. Successful by Kirsten Green and the holder, Ebony Montgomery. The field goal team put it together in a big, big way. And Pittsburgh gets three and takes a 10-point lead with 9.5 minutes left in the third period of play. 31-21, Passion.
Kirsten Green, a great addition to the Pittsburgh Passion. That had been a component of the Passion's game that had been missing for a few years. Nice to have the field goal threat as an option.
That was a huge kick.
Huge.
And a big rush coming from Boston, too. She had to fend off the defenders that time who were coming at her.
Rookie showing the poise of a veteran out there.
Now Green, with a lot of confidence, is going to kick the football off to the Boston Renegades here. The lights are on at Joseph P. DeMichela Stadium in Imperial, PA, in the West Hills of Pittsburgh. Bouncing ball at the 28-yard line, and it'll finally be covered up. Looked like Sarah Tully was back there.
Coming on for their first defensive series of the half. Totals from the first half, you've got Hannah Damon with 4 tackles and an INT. Tia Montgomery with 5 tackles. And Niedermeyer with 6 tackles and 1 sack. Let's see what they can build upon now, Chris.
Good numbers so far, Jennifer, no question. 31-21, those are the most important numbers in this ball game. Pittsburgh up by 10 with 9:25 left. Third quarter action. Allison Cahill back in at quarterback, hands off. This is Pasquale. She'll run to the right side. And Pasquale over the 30, ahead to the 33-yard line. She'll pick up 4 on the rush. Niedermeyer was there again for Pittsburgh. Second down and 6 for Boston. Cahill, play fake, throws. Incomplete. She overthrew her intended receiver, Stephanie Pasquale, that time. Good double coverage by Pittsburgh in the secondary.
Yeah, they did a great job keeping Pasquale in between them.
Third and 6 now for the Renegades. 3 receivers to the left side. Cahill looking left the whole way, and this pass is going to be broken up. It was intended for Bonds that time, but the Passion able to bust that play up, and coming in there for Pittsburgh was Ashley DeSico.
Ashley DeSico able to read Cahill, who was broadcasting where she was throwing, and just got her hand in it right at the right moment.
Looking left the whole way. You better believe she telegraphed that or broadcasted, as you said, very happily. Fourth down and 6 to go now, and Boston is in punt formation with 8:19 left in the third. Looping snap, controlled and booted. And it'll go out of bounds with no return. And again, Pittsburgh's going to come up with excellent field position, excellent starting position here for this next drive. They'll have the ball at the Boston 45-yard line.
Now, if they can just manage those miscues of the first series of the false starts, they can get up on them quick again.
Pittsburgh with a 2-0 victory, a forfeit victory over Cleveland in the first game this year. And, of course, this is their first real on-field test, full-out football test
right.
of this season.
Yeah, 2 weeks ago in Cleveland, it was a controlled scrimmage due to the forfeit. So it was an opportunity to work some kinks out with some rookies and vets. But this is the first real test, and they're stepping up to the challenge for sure.
Pittsburgh didn't have enough players out there. Crystal Kozo steps off the sideline and into formation as the wideout right. Blitz coming from Boston.
Lisa Horton feels it, reads it, throws it downfield. A twisting turnaround try by Angela Baker comes up empty on the strike down to the 20-yard line.
If the Boston defender just turned her head, she was in better position to catch that underthrown ball, but she was too busy chasing Angela Baker down.
Coverage that time by Deanna Walsh of Boston. Second down and 10. Again, Boston showing blitz. Horton, check with me to the sideline. New receiver in for Pittsburgh. The wide side right wide out is Ellison Malarski. Here's a run play and a sweep by Catone. Turns it upfield, 40, 35. Catone cut back, 30. Zigzag, 25. Catone inside the 20-yard line. Brought down at the 19. First down, Pittsburgh. A great run by Tara Catone.
She is just a tremendously agile, powerful runner, and you see her showcase the speed, able to stop, pivot on a dime, pick up speed again. Dodge defenders, an amazing job and run by Tara Catone there.
She's back to herself, isn't
she?
She
is. I mean, it's clear, undeniably.
First and 10 in the Silver Sports Silver Zone. Come the Pittsburgh Passion from the 19-yard line. 7:37 left third quarter. Pittsburgh by 10, 31-21. Four wide set once again for Horton. Gets the snap. Sends one down over the middle. Baker! Touchdown, Pittsburgh!
I'm wondering if that was a bit of a late hit on Lisa Horton. Don't see a flag, but nonetheless, it's a touchdown pass. Lisa Horton to Angela Baker. Again, slippery rock to slippery rock. Must be a great night.
Must be slippery rock. Angela Baker was slippery all the way down in the end zone, running to the post at 7:20 left here in the third period of play.
That's Baker's second touchdown on the night.
This one from 19 yards out from Lisa Horton. Green is on to kick. It's up and away, and good. Pittsburgh leads 38-21 over the Boston Renegades with 7:20 remaining in the third. Passion were up 14 points with 3:06 to go in the second period, but Boston scored with 41 seconds left in the half to cut it to 28-21 Pittsburgh. And you kind of had a feeling that Boston had gained the momentum back
right, going
into the locker room despite the fact that they were down, but Pittsburgh came out, socked him hard, went up by 10 with a Kirsten Green 30-yard field goal, 31-21. And then that strike from Horton to Baker. That puts Pittsburgh up 38-21 right now as Boston will look to try to regroup. Now remember, there's still plenty of time left in this game. 7:14 here in the third, plus the entire fourth period of play. And this is Boston. This is the Boston Renegades that Pittsburgh has the lead on right now. But don't count them out. They have the ability to come back.
They certainly have all the weapons. There was Gabby O'Neill. Give her credit for getting it done again on special teams, bringing down the ball carrier.
Allison Cahill's back in there, quarterback. Here's a screen pass over to the left side, caught by Bonds. Slips a tackle up to the 40, 45. Look at Bonds, able to break another tackle, and she'll dance to the sideline for a first down for the Boston Renegades. And finally cleaned it up. Tia Montgomery came in there and did it, along with a little bit of help from Niedermeyer. Coming over, Santana Ramsey finished off the tackle. Uh-oh, they're going to call this one back, though.
Block in the back is the call on the field.
Beneke whistled for that penalty. Boston had a bright spot there, and then it just faded, unfortunately, for them. So instead of being in passion territory or close to it, they are now back to their own 26. First down and 20. The down and distance now for Cahill. Cahill dances back, runs out to the right and is hit from behind and sacked on the play. Tremendous effort for Pittsburgh again.
And Damon. Oh, 45. I'm sorry. I'm giving credit to the wrong person. Kelsey Edmonds.
That time, Cahill barely got back to the line. Second down 20, they're calling it. Cahill, good footwork. Now throws out near side, and it's batted down, incomplete. Another fabulous play by Santana Ramsey on the intended receiver, Catherine Thailander.
Santana doing a great job keeping her elbow on the receiver to have field awareness about where she is while her head's turned looking for the ball and timed her jump just perfectly. Excellent coverage.
And Santana Ramsey, another Slippery Rock grad.
Hey,
on Slippery Rock night.
It's in the water today.
Third down and a little more than 20 now for Boston. And change up running backs. Susan Sheldon checks in and she'll replace Pasqua. Uh-oh, bobbled snap. Throw out right and another, this is going to be a double throw play,
ball.
But they never get the pass off. And we're going to get a penalty flag on the tackle as the ball goes down at the 19-yard line. They were trying to throw the double pass. Let's see what the call's going to be here with 5:58 left in the third.
I would have thought that was a live ball, but...
They're going to call it an illegal forward pass by Emily Beneke. What they were trying to do is throw the ball over to the sideline and get the double pass going, but the original pass went forward by a yard.
Yeah. And here I was thinking she was behind the line of scrimmage and she dropped the ball. It'd be a live ball, and our girls, the black and gold, looked like they had come up with it. So this scenario works out better for Boston.
It does. So a loss of down for Boston as well. And now they're going to have to put the ball away. 5:58 left, third quarter of play. Pittsburgh 38-21. 17-point lead over the Renegades.
You can't tell who's in the backfield there.
High snap. Punt is away. And it started taking a Boston roll, then it hooked back for Pittsburgh there. And no return by Gabby O'Neill. She'll just watch it get tapped down. Yep, here comes Lisa Horton and the offense of Pittsburgh once again here. Good defensive stand that time by Pittsburgh. As we were saying before, you cannot count this Boston Renegades club out.
You can't, and you know, and the easiest way to kill the momentum is to drive the ball down the field, of which they're quite capable of doing, but some great defensive plays, a number of them by Santana Ramsey.
Here comes Baker in motion. It's going to be an option play. And Lisa Horton will run it around the left end and run it forward to the 39-yard line for a 6-yard pickup.
Jones at 89-yard rushing.
Second down and 4 yards to go now for Pittsburgh. Two slot receivers to the right side this time for Horton, and we get a flag. Ball start Pittsburgh.
They didn't announce the number though. Tara Catone has 89 rushing yards so far on the night, working her way towards that century mark.
It looks like she's out right now. Foster is back in. On second down and 9. It's going to be Foster running the football. And
and she's able to shake loose for about three. Third down and about six to go. Horton pulled it back out, runs forward, first down. Lisa Horton down to the 33-yard line.
They were some Renegade defenders fooled by that, going after Foster in the backfield while Lisa's taking off north.
Clock continues to roll. 4:20 left here in the third period of play. Pittsburgh by 17 over Boston.
This is Lisa's sixth game.
First down and 10 now for the Passion. Get a little tightened on offense now. We're going to see Baker roll across the set in motion, but another call here. Another false start. The officials are seeing something on the line of scrimmage, and I'm not sure what.
Yeah, and the one was charged against 99, Veronica Burris.
So it's first down and 15. Foster stays in the backfield. Baker comes across the back of the set to the right. Here is Horton. She got nailed as she let go of that ball, which is caught over on the near sideline by Malarski, the rookie out of Slippery Rock, and she catches it at the 32, but Lisa Horton got clobbered on that hit as she let go of the ball.
And that hit was laid on her by Genero.
Allie Genero, one of the hardest hitting linebackers in this league. And we've seen that again tonight. Randy Cosgrove, the PA announcer, just making it official that Ellison Malarski just made her first career reception as a member of the Pittsburgh Passion, the young rookie.
Special moment for her, for sure, especially against a team of this caliber.
Second down and 10 after she picks up five on her first career reception. Malarski stays in it wide out right. Baker is in the slot. One receiver left. The handoff goes to Foster. Foster, took a hit, gave a hit simultaneously, and Foster is hit hard at the 24-yard line or 29-yard line and popped down. Tara Catone comes back in to play running back after Foster was knocked out for a second. Knocked out of the ball game, not knocked out. Here's Horton rolling left, setting, throwing sidearm, playing downfield, and it led the receiver too far and it goes incomplete. Meister, the intended receiver, running the fly down the outside of the numbers. And now Pittsburgh looking at fourth down and long.
You know, Lisa has five touchdowns on this game tonight. This is her sixth game in which she's been able to accomplish that. It's absolutely incredible.
You've always said, pound for pound, maybe the greatest quarterback ever to play in Pittsburgh.
I would agree.
And yeah, I'm talking about you know who. Fourth down and long. Horton. They fake the jet sweep. Baker will take the handoff and then
throw it
downfield and the ball's caught.
Catches it anyway.
And that's Malarski, the rookie, once again, down at the 5-yard line, making a great catch, fighting off the defender.
24-yard catch there while she was getting mauled the entire time. Glad to see some yellow flags on that field after that one, Chris, but the toughness she exhibited there, amazing.
What an imaginative play. They set up as if they're running Baker on the jet sweep. Baker takes the handoff, stops down in her tracks, and then heaves it downfield. Incredible. 1:49 left here in the third. Pittsburgh in the Silver Sports Silver Zone again. The officials need to chat before they get this next snap off. 38-21, Pittsburgh in the lead over Boston. First down and goal. Ball spotted at the six. Horton steps up in the pistol once again. Gives it off to Catone. Catone trying to power her way downfield. And let's see. She just got back to the line, and that's it, Jennifer. Just too much power for Boston that time.
There's a lot of size in there for the Bucs on Boston's side of the ball.
We were commenting before the game started. We were on the field talking about how big that Boston team is.
Yep.
Horton with Catone behind her again. Now Hannah Damon is going to slide down the line of scrimmage, the H-back left. Horton's going to follow them, flag in the air. Lisa trying to find some room, zigzags. She'll get back to the line, and another flag comes down, and that's it. Burris whistled for the holding call that will stand. The motion penalty won't be needed here. That's declined by Boston, so they'll take the more major of the infractions, the more severe, if you will. And that will push the ball out beyond the 15-yard line to the 16. Second down and goal to go from there. Horton gives off. It's good to see Kia Foster back in the ball game, and Foster is zigzagging around the left side and found a yard, and that's all. And Boston again has come alive defensively here, and they need to get a big stop right now. Yeah. Unnecessarily saying so because they're down 17.
Right. You know, and one of the threats that we're not seeing back on the field yet is number 8, Sharon Vasquez. Tough as a blocker for those running backs to get around the edge, but also a threat as a receiver.
Well, you heard the horn in the background, perhaps. That's the end of the third period of play here at Joseph P. DeMichela Stadium in Imperial, Pennsylvania. Here at West Allegheny, Chris Shovlin with Jennifer Cairns, former Pittsburgh Passion star and her former club, the one we're watching out there on the field, is up 17 on the Boston Renegades, 38-21. And you're watching Pittsburgh Passion TV. Pittsburgh with the 38-21 lead over the Boston Renegades as we head to the fourth period of play. Jen, Passion getting it done so far in this game.
They are, you know, but we talked about this early on. They can't get complacent. They got to be able to ride the waves. You know, this Boston team is capable of scoring quickly, and they have a full quarter of play left.
Trip set, right side for Lisa Horton as the Passion have it. Third down and goal to go. Horton calls her own number, runs forward. Again, handling that ball loosely out there, but she takes a whack. Hangs on as she reaches the 7-yard line.
It's almost as though she's taunting them, and she's done it her whole career, you know, and she's got such a strong grip. She's incredibly powerful, but you'd like to see her tuck it in.
She is such a great competitor. Mm-hmm. And she continues to breathe fire. I mean, let's face it, she's in her 16th year playing professional football now.
She is, and she's had her fair share of injuries. It's not like she's not been beaten up over the years. You see it. She likes to call her own number. She likes to put the game on her shoulders when it matters.
Pittsburgh will go for another field goal here. This will be a 25-yard attempt. Kirsten Green already has a 30-yarder in this game. Hold by Montgomery. Here's the kick, and this one is going to get blocked. This one gets blocked. Boston gets a piece of it. And they will recover and take over. The injury to one of the Boston Renegades. And now Boston, after blocking the Pittsburgh field goal attempt, takes over first down and 10 at their own 20-yard line. And they've got some work to do, but there's still plenty of time to go. Almost the entire fourth period is left. 38-21, Pittsburgh in the lead over the Renegades. Next week, the DC Divas will be here in Pittsburgh to take on the Passion. And that will be another tough one. Here's Cahill throwing out left side. Bonds makes the grab, gets nailed immediately after about a 3-yard gain. Looked like DeSico coming out of the secondary to make the tackle. Gain of 3, second down, a little more than 7 to go now. Motion out to the left side by Pascoe. Here's Cahill, back to pass, throws down over the middle. This one is going to be caught after a little bit of a wrestling match. And Beneke, making the grab out of the air, takes it down to the 29. Just shy of the first down, it's third down and less than 1.
That was Kozo on the coverage wrestling for that ball. Unfortunately, she was unable to shake it loose.
Cahill, play fake, pop pass over the middle. It's going to be complete. Bonds making the grab. And Bonds goes down hard underneath Hannah Damon at the 39-yard line. Now they're going to move the chains. They're going to say it touched the 40, first down and 10. Boston with the football in the hurry up now. Trailing by 17 points with 13-13 left. Here's a run by Pascal. She'll get it up for a 1-yard gain. They are hitting hard out there on this field today.
Hitting hard, moving fast. Got ourselves a battle out there.
Gain of about 1. Second down, a little more than 9 yards to go. Trip set to the left side for Cahill. She drops back, steps up, fires downfield, hit as she lets go of the ball. And Beneke, again, fielding another tough catch at the Pittsburgh 41-yard line, holds on and moves the chains again.
Showing you time and time again why she's Allison Cahill's favorite target.
Again, Boston in the quick step right now. 12:20 to go. Clock continues to wind. They're down 17 underneath Pittsburgh, 38-21. Pascal in motion left. Cahill drops back, looks right, throws right. Incomplete. Threw it over everybody that time. Closest receiver to the football was Thailander. And Damon was there, and so was Ramsey once again. I know we've said this in past seasons. Hannah Damon, still a college student playing for the Pittsburgh Passion. She's on the crew at Robert Morris University, just a few miles up the street.
Yeah, she's been a great addition to the team, and how she balances the demands of both sports going forward at the same time is quite amazing.
Pass, left side, caught by Pascal. She's at the 30. Sidesteps the tackler, 25. Gets by another, down to the 20-yard line. And Boston comes up with a badly needed first down into the Silver Sports Silver Zone now for them.
Pascal was completely unattended to out there in the flat, and then she just used her speed and footwork to dodge the defenders once they caught up to her.
Mentioned Hannah Damon playing both sides of the ball tonight as the H-back on offense, linebacker on defense. We'll get to that in just a second here as the throw goes to the end zone and a touchdown reception by Stephanie Pascal, who started the scoring here tonight. She gets Boston back on the board with 11:32 to go here in the fourth period of play. And I've told you once, I've told you a couple of times, don't count the Renegades out. This is a quick strike ball club, and they are in comeback mode right now. They're down by 11 after that TD, and they can possibly make this a 10-point game if they can get the kick through the pipes. Brooke Goodman is on. Placement is down, kick is away, and it's a wobbler, but it gets through.
So it's a 10-point game now. Passion 38, Boston 28, 11:32 left in the game.
We're going to get an illegal substitution call here if they don't watch out. Fortunately, Boston wasn't quite ready, and now they run up out of the scrum and pull off the onside kick, and again, Pittsburgh does recover. It's a sneaky trick play, and Boston is very good at running this run-up out of the huddle.
They are very good, but you're playing with fire, right? Because they're giving equally strong field position to a tremendously talented offense that has the momentum right now.
That's the thing. If you don't secure that onside kick, if you don't get it back, then you're giving up field position. And that's exactly what they've done again. Pittsburgh with an excellent starting point here at the Boston 47-yard line. We have 11:30 to go in the game. Pittsburgh up by 10. Lisa Horton in at quarterback, sends Angela Baker in motion across the back of the set to the left. Horton, quick throw, left side, Baker makes the grab. Baker gets a block, Baker cuts to the near sideline and is dumped to the 40-yard line. A gain of 7 on the pass play.
And you could read where Lisa was going the entire time of that play. That was just executed really well. The blocks that her fellow wide receivers threw for Baker allowed her to skirt and get very nice positive yardage.
Sharon Vasquez out wide to the right side. Baker goes into the slot over on that side. Malarski the wide out near side, and Kozo is in the slot here. Catone out of the backfield now, shuffles over to the right as the running back. And Horton stuffed the ball into her and pulled it back out. And Lisa calls her own number, trying to go for the first down. Runs up close to it, but that stopped a little bit shy on a good tackle by Charlene Casey. It's going to be third and one for Pittsburgh now with 10.5 minutes left in the game. Passion by 10 over Boston, team that finished in the national championship game, losing to Dallas by 10 last year. Horton, again calling her own number, taking a hit and getting the first down. She is tough.
She is. She's determined to win this game.
Passion Drumline picking up the beat right now. First down from the 35-yard line. Pittsburgh in Boston territory. Again, Baker comes sliding left. Horton hits her, but the ball came out.
Oh.
And that's an incomplete pass, I thought. I have to question if that was an incomplete forward pass, and I think that's why the Boston defense went after that ball, thinking it might have been a lateral ball.
Yeah, it was hard to tell. It was close. I know I was a little nervous about whether she was in front of the line, behind the line. Well, they're going to get some luck on their side for the Passion, with a call against the Renegades.
Yeah, hit to the face by Mia Brickhouse. That's the call. And a personal foul will move the football all the way down to the Boston 19.
Mia Passion. Brickhouse is a familiar name to Pittsburgh Passion, but usually not in a Renegades jersey, except for the last couple years. She used to be a longtime DC diva.
They had a wild one with DC last week, didn't they?
They did.
There's Baker again, this time going to the right. Horton looking for her, finds her. And a jump catch, but they're going to end up losing a yard. Good coverage that time by Boston and Vicky Eddy making that stop, forcing the loss.
Open field tackles aren't easy, so she did her job there and just held on as Angela Baker tried to make a move.
Three Passion receivers to the left side this time on second down and about 12. Horton again sends Baker right. Whistles and flags.
That one on Vasquez.
Penalty squirts the ball backwards to the 26-yard line. How about that pass hooked out of the air at the 15-yard line with a tremendous jump catch.
Incredibly, you know, incredible display of athleticism there. Bring that ball down.
Meister hooking that one out of the clouds. Nope, they're going to rule that incomplete. I thought she had it. Ruled it incomplete. Third down. Option pitch, Catone to the left. And there she goes with that stop and go move again and able to pick up a couple of extra yards after pulling that off. She'll get it down to about the 23-yard line. But it's fourth down. Fourth down and about 14 yards to go. We're under 8 minutes left in the ball game. It's a 10-point game. Boston knows if they can get a stop here, this is doable for them. So Pittsburgh is going to have to play this one smart. Horton looking at her receivers on both sides. Straight drop, pump, step up, and a zip pass down over the middle is going to be incomplete. There was some contact down there, but ball was up for grabs. And Boston will take over on downs. Now look out for the Renegades here. Their defense is going to have to play as well as it can. This is a quick strike club. They can go into the hurry up at the drop of a hat, and I'm guaranteeing you, Jen, that they're going to do just that right now. They're going to be in the hurry up offense the rest of this game.
I mean, they need to from a clock management perspective, but they've also had tremendous success against catching the passion defense off guard and not being able to adjust.
Allison Cahill tries to set the screen over to the left side. She was under a lot of pressure and threw off her backpedaling feet that time, and incomplete, intended for Angelica Pasquale. Second down and 10 now for Boston. Clock stops with the incomplete pass. Ball inside the 24. 7:24 remaining. Chance of defense coming out of the crowd now. A little bobbled snap that time. Cahill collects it, throws downfield, has a streaking receiver in bounds, makes it over the shoulder grab, and drives it all the way down to the 24-yard line. Shante Bonds on the fly, able to beat two passion defenders and then fight them off.
There's a flag on the field.
Way back upfield at the line of scrimmage. Boston called for an illegal receiver downfield, so wipe that play right off of your books. A great pass play from Cahill to Bonds, nullified by penalty.
We got Samantha Simeone on the sideline trying to rouse the crowd. It's working.
Well, she's into it.
This game matters.
And it's Boston. Second down and 15 after the penalty that nullified the big pass play down to the 24. Low snap, Cahill picks it up. Wants to throw, is going to run. 25, up to the 30. And over to the near boundary line, flushed out of bounds on the play. That will stop the clock. She was able to scramble out of bounds. Crystal Kozo was going to make sure she wasn't going to be able to get any further upfield. Still shy of the first down marker, too. At the 32-yard line is where she went out. Third and two for Boston. Well, the clock continued to run. I guess she did not get tackled out of bounds, rather inbounds. Play fake, and now the throw out to the left side to no one. Bonds was the intended receiver. Meister was the closest defender. Now Boston is looking at fourth down and two. They need a fresh set of downs in the worst way, so don't be surprised if they just try to run to try to get the first down.
Well, especially because the coverage of the passion is showing and they're just playing, you know, leaving that open running room for Cahill to call her own number, grab the first down, and then start rocketing it down the field with a new fresh set of downs.
They will run. And just getting past the marker and gaining a yard past that is Pasquale. She'll pick up about three or four on that run play, but that's good enough for the Boston first down with 6:03 to go in the football game. Chains will be moved. They'll advance. Cahill has another set of downs to work with. 38-28 Pittsburgh. Boston in possession. Time now winding against the Renegades. Pasquale, the running back, finds a couple up the middle up to about the 39-yard line. That'll be a 3-yard gain. Now Boston with 5.5 minutes left, Jen. They're going to have to go up top.
They're going to have to. I mean, they can't waste time trying to dink and dunk with, down the field with runs.
Here goes the first attempt at it. There's Bonds over the shoulder catch, and she could be gone. But no, she's tackled from behind at the 3-yard line. Angela Baker made the stop and saved the touchdown.
Angela Baker not willing to give up. The rest of the, looks like we might, nope, not an injury, just tying the shoe.
Snap, Cahill gives it to Pasquale. She'll run, try to spin, takes it down inside the 2-yard line. I want to go back to that track down tackle made by Angela Baker to save the TD because it looked like Shante Bonds was gone.
It did, but Angela Baker, not to be denied, she wants to win this game as much as anyone out there on the field. Playing both sides of the ball, it's amazing she has that stamina.
Now Pasquale will dive into the end zone for the touchdown, and Boston gets on the board to tighten this game up with 4:44 to go. They're down only by four now. How large that 30-yard field goal looms in this game when you get right down to it. But remember, Boston needs to get the extra point here to bring it into a field goal game. They're going to bring Goodman on to kick. They don't have enough personnel out there, and somebody's going to hurry up and rush in late. As a matter of fact, it was the holder of all people getting out there late, Vicky Eddy. Snap, placement, kick.
Blocked! It's blocked!
Two block kicks in this game, one by Pittsburgh right here, and of course one earlier by Boston, and this one is huge as the Passion maintain a 4-point lead.
Yeah, I think Boston's actually had two, so this is the third blocked field. There was one blocked point after, two point afters for Boston, and now one for Passion.
Brooke Goodman will kick, expect an onside. Instead, she's going to pop it up, so she fooled everybody. And the return is on to the near side, and this is Gabby O'Neill of 40, 45. Gabby on the gallop up to the 49-yard line, and here come the flags.
Everywhere. Not possibly wanting to risk giving the Passion good field position again. Opting to kick it. Gabby O'Neill, one heck of a run back. Personal foul is going to give them even more yardage.
Well, even though they've decided to kick away, it kind of backfired on them. And now, after O'Neill's return to the 49, tack 15 more yards onto that. And the Passion will have the football at the Boston 36-yard line, just outside of the 36. It's going to be first down and 10, Pittsburgh. Passion lead by four, 38-34 with 4.5 left.
Passion got to capitalize on the gift that they were just handed to them. Mm-hmm.
Wrapped with a big bow, too. Chris Shublin, Jennifer Cairns on the call here tonight. Classic ball game between Pittsburgh and Boston here in women's professional football. We knew it was going to be a good one. We've got a really good one going on here. Three receivers to the right side for Lisa Horton in the pistol. Gives off to Tara Catone. Catone is staggered. And here comes the flag out from behind the play. As we saw, the initial hit pulled off by Danielle Fournier. Boston. Personal foul. And it was Fournier who was called for the face mask penalty.
Tara Catone doing a good job ducking under that first defender, keeping her legs moving, just trying to get whatever she could. She's tough as nails out there.
Face mask call will push the ball down to the Boston 23-yard line. Clock continues to tick away. 4:24 left in the football game. Pittsburgh with a first and 10. Horton looks over her shoulder, checks the game clock. She's taking her time. Taking air out of the ball, if you will. Boston showing blitz again. Horton catches the snap, whips one over to the left side to Meister, who on the spin around could not bring it down.
Taking the air out of the ball has a whole different reference to the Pittsburgh-Boston matchup, just not this one.
Now I know who you're talking about.
Yes.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Foster checks back in at running back. I'm not even sure who had the ball. Was it Horton or was it Foster?
It seemed like they were battling it, almost like Horton was going to pull it back, but Foster had it in her hands.
And breaking up that play was Charlene Casey. Slippery Rock University night here at the Pittsburgh Passion home opener. There's a lot of Passion players claim Slippery Rock is their alma mater. Tonight's game being brought to you by UPMC Sports Medicine, by Silver Sport, Post Acute Medical, Aid Nation, by Super Donut, and by Slippery Rock University. It's third down and 12 for the Passion. Horton gives off. This is Kia Foster. And Foster stacked up and tossed down. Clock will stop at 3:41 to go. Boston calls another timeout. Jen, how do you think these young members of the Passion have done here tonight, blending with the veterans?
I think they're doing an excellent job. I mean, this is an opponent unlike any that they've seen or could have thought to face. I mean, they practice against themselves, which is a good practice squad, you know, to say the least. And they're not showing any signs of nerves out there, which is pretty impressive.
Fourth down and 9. Horton pumps, steps up, throws down over the middle.
Incomplete,
but flags everywhere. Going to be a pass interference call as Jana Meister turned, tried to reach back for the ball, and had one of the Renegades draped all over her.
Jana Meister doing her best to try to break loose and shake coverage, and they are battling for a while, and as she turns to the ball, you're right, Chris, the Renegade defender just jumped on her back.
Yeah, defender was Torres, and she was flagged for the pass interference call. So the spot of the football will be at the 6-yard line. First down and goal, Passion after the pass interference penalty. And the Passion
looking to get a score here to stretch this lead. Only four right now. Touchdown could just put this one away. High snap, Horton able to find it. And Lisa Horton somehow, some way, snakes her way down to the 4-yard line. Second down and goal to go from the 4. Coming down to the 3-minute mark. Horton again taking her time, just having the offense stand there while she communicates with the sideline. Foster, the single running back. A 4-receiver set in. Horton again had to control a high snap, throws end zone, incomplete. That time the receivers didn't even look for the football. A little miscommunication on that pass play, apparently. Kozo was running out to the corner. Meister was running to the post, and that ball was thrown between the two of them. It's now third down and goal to go from the 4.
And because of the high snap, she was just forced to get rid of it without really looking where they were, thrown to a spot.
Baker sliding right. Vasquez is already over there. High snap again. And Horton gives it up. It's Kia Foster running to the goal line. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. 2:39 remaining in the football game. And the Passion again are up by 10.
Kia Foster, who had been the workhorse of this quarter running the ball for the Pittsburgh Passion, finally gets pay dirt with a very powerful run. And that is her 10th career rushing touchdown in the black and gold jersey. And they have 44 on the scoreboard. That's a good number.
You like that number. That's the number you used to wear.
But they're about to get 45, so.
That's up to Kirsten Green. She puts her foot into it. No, they're going to stick at 44, Jen, just for you.
Just for me. I am sorry about that, ladies.
44-34, Pittsburgh by 10. 2:39 to go as the kick fails. Passion leading and trying to go 2-0 on this young football season with the DC Divas coming to Pittsburgh next Saturday night. Rookie Kirsten Green getting set to kick. Native of Western New York. Run up and delivery. Taken and
reverse
to Bonds. And Bonds is going to be trapped and decked at the 35-yard line. So the kick originally fielded by Sarah Tully. Tully running over to Shante Bonds on the reverse, giving it off, and they end up picking up an extra yard, and that's all.
Great special teams play there by the Pittsburgh Passion.
Ten-yard penalty for a block in the back on that return play as well, so add insult to injury there. Another 10-yard mark off against Boston. Big night for the Passion here tonight. 2:29 remaining in the football game. Pittsburgh leads 44-34, but Boston with the ball. Look out. They're going to throw everything at Pittsburgh now. Cahill over to the left side. Screen pass caught. This is Pascal. Pascal still on her feet, rushing all the way out to the 44-yard line. Good run after the catch. And it's a first down for Boston. And here they come.
She put a good move on the first Passion defender she met in the open field. Then she turned on the Jets for the first down.
Cahill, play fake, looks. Flush to the right, throws, and that one is caught. Her favorite target, Beneke, makes another catch right at the sideline and then jumps out of bounds. Stopping the clock with 1:59 to go in the game. Another first down for Boston. And now they're into Pittsburgh territory at the 45. Cahill. Over the middle. Incomplete, but flags.
We're
going to get a penalty here as Beneke, the intended receiver, got hooked down by Crystal Kozo of Pittsburgh. It's a spot foul, so where Crystal Kozo made contact with Beneke was the 39-yard line. It's a first down for Boston. 1:53 to play. Pasquale getting the handoff, looping through the line, and finally getting put down on the play on the rush. That time it was Bovic.
Got Vasquez coming in for help in the secondary.
Second down, less than five down for the Renegades. Clock spinning, under a minute and a half to play in the game. Cahill looks over the middle and chucks. And it's incomplete off the fingertips of Stephanie Pasquale. The incompletion will stop the clock from ticking. 1:20 remaining in the ball game. Pittsburgh by 10, 44-34 over Boston. Third down and five. Cahill with time now, chased, floats right, throws downfield. Beneke catches the football at the hip at the 4-yard line and then runs into the end zone for a score. I told you Boston had some life left in it, and they're showing it right now. 1:09 remaining in the game, and it's back to a 4-point affair. They're going to kick for the extra point. Brooke Goodman is on. Remember, Pittsburgh missed its last PAT. Snap is high but controlled, and Goodman puts it through from her toe, and now it's a field goal game again. The Passion holding on by three, 44-41, with a minute 9 remaining in this ball game. And we always talk about how extremely important special teams are. We're seeing it play out here tonight, aren't we?
We are. You know, they make their last Passion make their last PAT. It remains a 4-point game, a touchdown required by the Boston Renegades. Now the hands team of the Pittsburgh Passion has got to be on point and then kill the clock.
Are we seeing a passing exhibition here tonight by these two quarterbacks?
We are. I mean, it's always been a shootout. Both quarterbacks are equally skilled. They usually lead the leaderboards for the Cross WFA year after year. Both quite talented women.
I'm just trying to keep it. Pittsburgh by three. Watch for the onside kick. I didn't even have to say that, did I?
Wait, what's the officials are?
Pittsburgh called a timeout before the kick was let go. So Boston's going to have to do that again. Pittsburgh had called the timeout with a minute 9 remaining. And the Passion right now talking strategy, talking about being safe with this football, being cautious, this onside kick. Let's see if the strategy session paid off. Pittsburgh calling the timeout before Boston had a chance to boot the ball. Expect the onside kick. Pittsburgh does. We all do. Goodman's going to put her toe into it. Steps up, launches it perfectly. It bounces.
Black jersey.
Black and gold do pull it in. I'll tell you one thing. You know, Boston has pulled off these onside kicks time and time again tonight, and Pittsburgh has been able to fend them off and recover.
You know, they've watched enough film on Boston to know that that was coming and practiced it relentlessly, and it looks like, you know, how you practice is how you execute, and so great job to the Passion Special Teams.
And a great job to that coaching team, too.
Absolutely.
Getting these gals ready for this ball game tonight, and every possibility, including the onside kicks, which we've seen so much of. Head coach Teresa Kahn with Joe Tindall, Sarah Niedermeyer, Mike Melnick, Robert Hutchinson, Aaron Reese, Tina Reutis, David Rubis, Evander Wright, Nick Lanero, Devin Nessler, Denzel Jackson, Jesse Hutchinson, and Stephen Winkler helping out as well. First down and 10, victory formation called for by the Passion. They get the snap. And immediately, the officials will signal a timeout. Their third and final timeout for the Boston Renegades. So the clock stops with 1:06 to play in the game. The Passion lead by 3, a slim field goal margin, 44-41. And a great game here tonight in the West Hills of Pittsburgh.
I mean, it's been a battle. We've seen it year after year. These matchups come down to the final seconds of the game. Today did not disappoint. We said at the beginning of the game it was going to be edge of your seat. I've been at the edge of mine all night. So
I got out of my seat. Now Lisa takes the snap from under center. And the clock will continue to run. We're down under a minute to go. And barring a crazy fumble, the Passion going to have to snap this one more time. Or are they? I believe they are. Yes, they will. They just have to take the clean snap, take the knee, and hang on for dear life. And they do. Celebration already beginning, already underway, and the Pittsburgh Passion have held off the Boston Renegades 44-41, and they've avenged the loss from last season, and Pittsburgh goes to 2-0, and what a tremendous event this was here tonight. The ball being winged all over the yard by both these quarterbacks. Lisa Horton and the Pittsburgh Passion hold on for victory here despite comeback efforts by the Boston Renegades. Final score here tonight, the Passion 44, Boston 41. Jennifer, what a thrill this was to call this game tonight.
It absolutely was, and this will be a big boost of confidence rolling into DC matchup next week, especially for the rookies. I mean, this was a true test of the rookies against a formidable opponent, how they would gel under pressure with the veteran crew, and I imagine the veterans were helping immensely in that regard, and it was a great collaborative effort.
Tonight, we just witnessed the second highest combined scoring game in Pittsburgh Passion history. The Passion and the Renegades chalk up 85 points here tonight at D. Michaela Stadium at West Allegheny. Stay tuned, we'll come back to recap the ball game. We'll have some post-game interviews. We'll head down to the field for those. That's all to follow right here. You're watching the Pittsburgh Passion on the Pittsburgh Passion Television Network. Final score tonight, Pittsburgh 44, Boston 41. Well, the Pittsburgh Passion victorious here tonight. We knew it was going to be a great game against the Boston Renegades, and it really, really was. Chris Shetland, Jennifer Cairns, we're back here with the starting quarterback, the leader of this ball club and this offense, Lisa Horton, one of the most prolific passers in the history of women's professional football. Lisa, tremendous effort here tonight, and I know that you kind of had the monkey thrown off of your back.
Yeah.
You just went over Boston tonight.
Oh,
tell
absolutely.
Us about it.
Tonight is a special night. I mean, we came with the focus, right, game one game at a time, and tonight we played as a team, played together, and we stayed resilient throughout the game. We made some mistakes, but we picked ourselves up right away and executed the next series. So as a team, it was amazing. It was amazing to see the chemistry we have from linemen to our running backs to, like, even just some of the blocks on our receivers and the catches you saw. It was just a fun night to play football.
beautiful night.
So a lot of rookies on this team, right, this year. What do you say to them after a win like this, you know, right, and to get them prepared for an equally formidable team next week in D.C.?
Right. Well, we got a lot of things to learn from. It was fun just to see their wide eyes in the locker room before the game, because this truly was our big home opener. But they, you know, they got a lot of the nerves out, and we have some really amazing rookies that are going to kind of continue on the passion tradition.
Tell us about the new offense. I know Mike Melnick is the head coach of Mount Lebanon. We were talking about that during the broadcast, Jan and I. And, you know, it's kind of a new-look offense for the Passion as well. There are a couple of new wrinkles there.
Yeah, I mean, it's a much quicker tempo. And we have the athletes to do it. I mean, Baker's obviously an amazing athlete. You got Tarik Tone, Kia Foster, and our line. And, it, you know, it took from day one. So he came in, and everyone's, like, a little apprehensive about it, including myself. But you trust, and you pray, and... You know, and I, even by the third week, we were moving the ball and everything's all signaled in. And it's magic to watch it happen because it's quick. And when you execute, it's good things happen.
Well, it's Slippery Rock night here tonight, yeah, right? And you're one of their proudest alumni. And so what would you say to any of those students who are sitting there cramming for finals right now who are thinking about doing this?
Oh, my goodness. Been there. Best of luck to your finals. but, yeah, if they're, you know, you have a dream to play for football, come on out, because we continually, every year, continue to build. So come on out.
It's a great night for Slippery Rock and all of your former classmates who are now members of the Pittsburgh Passion.
Yeah.
Let's take a look at what this victory means over the Boston Renegades and how this is going to stack Pittsburgh up as far as the rest of the league is concerned this year. What kind of message did this win send tonight?
I think the message is we're here to play. And we're ready to take it. We got to take one game at a time and be very methodical about that. DC's a very good team. So we'll be watching film, prepping probably tomorrow, tomorrow later, Monday, and then we'll be back right back at it. So to have these games back-to-back early in the seasons, you know, I think a good thing because it just we saw where we're at, and the score says that. So we played right with them through the end, and that's what makes it really exciting because there's a lot of season of ball. So.
Well, congratulations on a 5-touchdown game. We're told in the booth that that was your 6th one in your career. Not at all surprising to us. So we want to let you get in the locker room and enjoy it with the rest of the ladies.
Yeah, no, I definitely will. Thank you.
Just to share some of the numbers, 49 yards on the ground, but more importantly, 14 of 29 passing, 191 yards, and as Jennifer just said, 5 touchdowns here in this game tonight. It's a great
effort. Just the names work for Lisa Horton. That's all.
Another day at the office. That's all. And the Pittsburgh Passion win it by a final score of 44-41, and a tight finish, a great ball game that we saw here tonight. Special teams had a lot to do with it as well.
Yeah.
It was a huge night for the special teams. And that's our coverage of Pittsburgh Passion Football. Don't forget, the DC Divas come in next Saturday night. Jen, that's going to be another war.
It's going to be another edge of your seat. So, you know, come out and see and cheer them in real life. You know, they need that energy. They feed off of it, and it's what propelled them to a win tonight.
Fans. We need more.
Ask her. She can hear them. She can hear them from the stands. We'll see you next week.